Iggy Pop has been a rock legend for 30 years. Now he's releasing his 17th album, Naughty Little Doggy. In the first part of an exclusive interview, Toby Emmy's met the man behind the myth.
He's 48 years old and still a wild child. Iggy Pop is the man who's largely credited for making punk happen, which he wasn't too happy about at the time when Rolling Stone reviewed his first album.
And then they said, this is the sound of punks cruising for burgers. Like, what do you mean, punks? What do you mean, punk? F*** you, you know? You know, f*** you. Come on, mother f***. You know, I'll kill you, you know? And I felt like that, really, really angry and hurt. Obviously, later it became convenient to me, you know, because under that name, you know, people checked out my music.
And people did check out his music, and Iggy Pop gained a reputation for being a formidable and highly original performer. One night out in LA, I
met a Mexican. Is there a danger of your personality overshadowing your music?
Music comes from your personality, and I pretty much just do what I want to based on feeling. I feel it first, and then sniff around it, and kind of get in deeper and deeper, and sometimes f*** up on the way there, you know, and do something where later I go, oh, f***, this is really bad. I don't feel good about this anymore. How do I extract myself from it, et cetera, et cetera.
Most likely to succeed, ninth grade.
I've never, ever felt satisfied that, okay, I'm it. I never felt that, you know, ever.
Did you ever feel I'm there?
Yeah, most of the time. Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, sure. Yeah, when things are clicking right and something's coming back and forth, and a lot of times I don't know I'm there, and then later I realize, oh, I was there. That happens a lot too.
As a musician, his influence on the music scene has been enormous, and his reputation for hard living has been even greater. But these days, Iggy Pop has a calm approach to the wild side.
My life anymore doesn't add up to, okay, I make an album every couple of years, and the rest of the time I try hard to be on drugs and on my back. For me, at least, I found it like really important to do some other things, you know, just for the f***ing stimulation. Because otherwise, you know, what am I going to do? Sit around in my room and listen to old Iggy albums and call up somebody and say, hey, am I f***ing God? Yes, you're God. Oh, God. You know, I mean, that's not going to do me much good.
Something was in me and it had to come out.
My soul is also as up for grabs as anybody's. I mean, I don't think there's anybody particularly pure in this business. You know, you don't get on MTV with a clean ass.
And finally, you may remember that on MTV News recently
has a new album, Naughty Little Doggy.
And in the second part of our exclusive interview, Iggy tells Toby Emmys about his plans for the future.
Did you have like a mission statement? Did you have anything in mind that you wanted to do with it?
With?
The record.
No, fast food. I wanted it to be like quick and should be fun to listen to, should make me go like this, should make me smile when I hear it, and I should feel real good about the words, and when I'm not smiling, if it's more like something with more of another emotion, I should feel a wave of emotion when I hear it. That's what I was after, and get it in and get it out so it's not a bloody 75-minute trial to listen to. So that's what I was going for.
Who's gonna buy it?
Gonna buy it, or if anybody's gonna buy it. The only part I worry about is like, how can I make another record? That's what the money part means to me. How can I make another one, and another one, and another one, and so on and so on.
Among those next records, Iggy Pop is considering going back into the studio to work with his old band, the legendary Stooges.
So you don't think you'll be flogging a dead horse, creatively, working with the Stooges?
I have no idea. I don't know. It might be, it might not. I just don't know. Do I just want to have somebody in my life that is really important and we did something together and la-di-da-di-da and then totally throw that away, have that trail off totally into oblivion and then have there be no no sort of thread, no humanity in the thing. That bothers me. That was the level on which Scotty approached it, but it was more like, well, hey man, you know, like we could have a reunion, you know? Just like that more, you know, hey, you know, I mean, we can play, you know, you wanna do blues, we can play blues. You wanna rock, we can rock. I'm, hey man, you know, it's more like that, but that's what the guy was trying to say to me, you know, so.
Isn't there a danger that the longer you stay in it, the more jaded you become?
I don't feel like I have to push it just to be hip, no. But is there a danger then that, you know, that you can totally just become unaware? Yeah, sure. Or that you become so inured to the shit that you need something farther afield, something that's more exotic to you? Yeah, in which case then it's time that you're gonna have to phase out of, obviously an arena you're not interested in is a place you don't belong. There are other forms of music that I'm making right now. I'm doing some acoustic score, you know, film score kind of music. Not like unplugged, not that dreadful, precious, soppy shit, you know, that everybody's flogging on MTV. But it's quieter music, and I wouldn't mind doing some sort of lounge singing either, you know, like with a piano, you know, just singing songs about, you know, your screwed up love life, that sort of thing. You know.
And apart from being a die-hard punk and piano-playing lounge lizard, Iggy Pop has also realized there's a lot of cash to be made by just being yourself.
The United States of America.
My coolest dad is, let's talk about my ads. My coolest dad is for Converse, though. They just took a tennis shoe and put it on some broken glass and stuck my name on it, and I didn't have to show up or anything. So that was really good, and I liked that because it's like a nyanyi at all the Americans dress. So, did you bring along the broken glass tonight? You know, you've mutilated yourself and abused yourself, you know. It's corporate now, mother kiss my ass. Brian.
Well, that's it for tonight's News at Night, where John Bon Jovi was lost for words and Bad Religion raced across Germany. On tomorrow.